So, good morning to one and all. The last class we were discussing about the MQTT protocol. Telemetry Transport Protocol for exchanging the data between the devices of the Internet of Things applications, basically for machine to machine exchange of data. A very lightweight protocol for exchange of data between the devices. So any queries for the introductory part which we have discussed in the last class related to MQTT or any other topics? Yes, please.
No, sir.
So if you might have seen this our course page, I have provided most of the materials that we are discussing for the last 1 week for various topics. So if you see from this, you have a connecting Raspberry Pi using SSH for reading DHT11 sensor data. So that today we will see the demonstration of that. This is what we have seen in the of course the last class. This is the digital temperature sensor KY028 connected to the Arduino board and then to the USB serial of Raspberry Pi to read the serial data. So if you see the material what I have given, let me show you, and it will be helpful for you to recap the discussions what we have done. So I have provided the photos, the connection part. So here, can anybody, are you able to see the images over here?
Yes, sir.
So in the material, you already, I have given you the complete the materials which we have now set up our own systems. Can anybody brief me about this particular system setup? What this particular system setup is doing? Of course, three figures related to the same setup, but in the different orientations. Can anybody tell me what is this setup is for? In your brief words.
So, like the temperature sensor is connected to the Arduino board, and temperature sensor is collecting the data and sending to Raspberry Pi via Arduino board.
Okay, so temperature sensor connected to the Arduino board, that is fine. You can see it on this diagram here. So clearly, on the second diagram, this is that. Digital temperature sensor. The digital temperature sensor basically, of course, I have not given the number here, KY028, this is, which is showing here the red color along with the potentiometer here, which is connected to your Arduino board. So once you, why did we connect to the Arduino board? What is the need for this one?
So for converting analog values to digital, ADC conversion.
Exactly. So we are connecting this KY028 to get the digital values over here. And this Arduino board on the right side, what you see is connected to the Raspberry Pi next to it using the USB serial port. So you can see it on the diagram, the other orientation also, you can see clearly what pins I have connected on the Arduino board. And this is on the right side of the figure. You see the pins connected to the Arduino board. And of course, if you see the demos of the earlier sessions, you'll video demos, you will see the connection point. And that particular Raspberry Pi, now this is what the Raspberry Pi, which we are now accessing. How do you access this Raspberry Pi? Of course, that is the one point. The Python program on this Raspberry Pi, I have given the Python code here, very simple code. So here in this Python code, what we are trying to do is we are importing one package called serial for reading the serial port data. So you are using a function here, serial. So this serial function is trying to connect to the one of your Raspberry Pi port. So that port is basically your TTY ACM0. And the baud rate, the data transfer from your Raspberry Pi to your machine, to your laptop, is basically your 9600 bits per second. So this, your object serial variable is being created, and this object variable, that serial, is reading the serial port data using the read line function, and it's converting to your string format, that is your UTF-8 code format, and that particular converted value you are trying to print it on your console window. So that's what, very simple program to read serial data from the Raspberry Pi. And to run this program, you need to connect to your WildRodin Studio NKS, that's what the Pi one, and you enter the code in the WildRodin IDE, and you run the program using your Python. So once you run it, you will get that particular corresponding ADC values. So once again, I'm just demonstrating here, connecting to the WildRodin Studio. Of course, there is a problem with this WildRodin Studio, because most of the time the server needs to be able to provide connections to us. So the sessions have to be connected here. Let me just check the Raspberry Pi. One second, I'll just restart the Raspberry Pi and we'll connect it. So this is one setup which we have done on one experiment to collect the data. That's what you can see it here. Now the second document is digital temperature sensor data, that again collecting the serial data and pushing into the cloud. I hope you have created your login accounts on your ThingSpeak cloud. Have you done it, please?
Yes, sir.
So your ThingSpeak cloud is this? Let me just check it, the WildRodin Studio, then we can go to the ThingSpeak cloud. Yeah, now the NKS Pi 1 is made available on the server. So whatever I told you, just let us run the program here once and see the output. So I went to the shell prompt. Then, so can you tell me the program name which I have written for you also? You can also access and you can see the program. So serial12.py. So once you run the program, you start getting the values. You can see it on the screen. There's a 205 and 1, the digital value, and this 205. So this is how this program, the same screenshots, I kept it here. You can see it on the same, this particular document, which is now available on you. This is what the output you are getting here. So this document, you can download it from the our course page. So let us now move to, in continuation to this one, the same data has to be pushed onto the ThingSpeak cloud. So how do we send the data to the ThingSpeak cloud?
Like using the MQTT protocol. MQTT.
Yeah, using, yes, of course, using the MQTT protocol.
Powerful MQTT.
Yeah, so I will just tell you once again, those who are not aware of this ThingSpeak, please go through this. Let me just sign out. So I'll tell the first step here. So once you come to your ThingSpeak cloud, this is how you need to just, this is a open source cloud for your IoT applications to display the data, and you can play with this. So you need not buy or you need not pay any money for this one. Just log in. So once you have to register here, so you can register. If you don't have an account, you create one. And if you register and you register whatever the email ID through which you are registered, you log in with that. And once you log in, let me show you the dashboard of this ThinkSpeak. So these are your dashboard or your my channels. What are the channels? Channels are nothing but the basically those are meant for you to collect the data from your IoT devices. So you have I have just NKS PyOne. Of course, these are I made it as a private channel for you. You can make it as a public channel too. So if you are making it as a public, it can be visible for all other users. If you make it as private, then it is only usable to you or to your team members. So here, of course, for demonstration purpose, I have given you the private view. You can make it as public view for your assignments. When you do the assignments, please make it as a public view. So once you create, you need to make sure that your API keys, those are the keys which are meant for you to connect to your program. So you can see there are two keys here, write API key and read API key. Write API key is meant for you to write something. It means you are collecting data from the IoT sensors. And that data which has been collected from the IoT sensors are going to be written or to be pushed onto the cloud. So you are writing something onto the cloud. When you are going to write something, or when you are going to collect the data, you are going to use this write API key. If you are going to read something from the cloud, then you need to use read API keys. Please have, understand the difference between write API and read API. Write API is meant for something to be written to the cloud. Read API is something which is to be read from the cloud. So since we are collecting the data, you need to use the write API key. Please remember this write API key. This is one thing. And the second thing is you can go to my profile, and you can have the MQTT API key. Please remember MQTT API key is also needed because you are now trying to give a demo on the MQTT protocol. So your user API key is there, all as well as your MQTT API key. If their MQTT API key is not available, you can just refresh it. You'll get the MQTT API key here. So this is how you get some keys from the ThinkSpeak cloud. Just these are meant for you to connect your program. Okay, now once you know, you can go to your My Channels again. Go to the My Channels. So I am this NKS PI. And of course, if you go to this channel settings, it will tell you. If you see here, there are 8 fields are there, field 1 to field 8. These 8 fields are meant for collecting the 8 different types of sensor data. Or you can see, read the data also and you can control it. So 8 fields are meant for there. That is, this is, since it is an open source, they have given you the provision to have play with 8 different types of data. So here the field 1, I just made one particular field so that you can collect the data from your digital temperature sensor. So one field has been here activated or it is enabled for you to collect the data. You click the save channel. Now once you click the save channels, then depending on the number of fields you selected, that many number of charts will be here. Since you selected only one field, that field one data is going to be displayed on this real-time chart. So of course, this is the previous data which when I was testing, I have collected the data. Let us now run the program for sending the data from your Raspberry Pi. So here, since we are discussing the MQTT protocol, so Raspberry Pi is made as a, can anybody tell me the Raspberry Pi is made as a, what type of unit? When we are discussing the MQTT, Raspberry Pi will be treated as what? Depending on the last week's, last class discussions, can anybody tell me?
Publisher.
Publish. Yes, you are going to make Raspberry Pi as a publisher. Publisher means it is publishing the data to the cloud. To whom it is publishing?
ThinkSpeak Cloud.
Yeah, ThinkSpeak Cloud. So ThinkSpeak Cloud is basically acting like a
subscriber.
It is not a subscriber, please, Sonali. It is not a subscriber. It is a
broker.
It is a broker. Yes, it is a server basically. ThingSpeak Cloud is a server. From the server, if you are collecting something, then that collecting person is to be called as a subscriber. That person can be a thing or it can be any application too. Please remember this. Very fundamental things related to IoT. Are you getting this point?
Yes, sir.
If you are not clear, please let me know. Again, I can explain to you. Until unless you don't understand MQTT properly, then it will be difficult for you. Introduction to MQTT, I have given the material here. Please look to the slides. I am not giving very huge material also. Please, at least the material which is given, please be perfect with that materials. Fundamentals, those are very much fundamentals for you to understand and to begin. And if you don't, if you are not clear with these fundamentals, then again, things will be very complicated. Please see here carefully. Look to this diagram, very simple diagram. You are publishing and subscribing. You are publishing something, your devices, your Raspberry Pi is going to publish it, and your MQTT broker is there on the ThingSpeak Cloud. And in this demonstration, you don't have any subscription. If there is a subscription, it can be an application. Please remember, it can be application or it can be any other device who is collecting the data, who is reading the data, or who is subscribing to the data. But in this application, we have only this one way. At present, in this demonstration, you will see only one way. You are sending the data from your client side to your broker, to your server. That is what we are trying to do here. Are you getting this point, please? Hello, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So let us open the program. Okay, now let us see the MQTT program which is publishing the data. Can you see the program now here?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So let me explain the program. We are in the halfway actually last class. So let me complete the program. I'll close all the screens here for you. And I will open the ThingSpeak Cloud so that simultaneously you can understand both the things. All right. So this is the program here. Can you see the program now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, just one second. I'm just a little bit confused, but the program which I executed, it is present in which particular directory? Okay, let us move ahead. Anyway, I'll work it once again. I think the program which has been not saved or something happened here. Anyway, so let us see. Okay. So the program here, we are trying to use the PAHO MQTT publish as a publish for your publishing the MQTT one, and you are using the serial package also to collect the data from the serial. So channel ID, what is the channel ID I'm using here now? 17137279. And what is the right API key? The API key which is need to connect to your cloud. So how do you get it from this? Go to the API keys. So this is the right API key. I'm copying it. And pasting it here. Right. And also I need the MQTT API key. The MQTT API key, I will get it from my profile. This is what your MQTT API key. Collect it and paste it here, right. So now I am using the TCP protocol to transmit my MQTT data. So why I'm using the TCP protocol? Can anybody tell me what is the reason behind collecting the TCP protocol, for using the TCP protocol to? Yes, please.
It's reliable.
It is reliable. Very good. So TCP is basically a reliable protocol for your data transmission. Data is not going to be lost as such. But let us see how the data is going to look here carefully. So now this is right. Now you are creating a topic. So what is the topic here? In the MQTT terminology, what does the topic contain? Yes, please. A topic contains what? A topic, basically, if you see our material I have given to you. So what is this events? Events means publishing the events. What does the events indicate? The something which is happening with the IoT devices, the data which is coming from the IoT devices, those are your events. And those events are pertaining to certain topics where you can categorize them for your different application purposes. Something like you can call it as you can topic, you can say that it is a toggle light. It is one topic. It is a number one in the particular room number one, or in room number two, or room number three. You have different types of lights, you have different types of fans, you have different types of devices, you have different types of rooms. So all those things can be treated as a topic. So it is basically a topic which will collect the data with respect to those devices. A topic indicates that. Similarly here, if you see here, this particular program, your topic is connected to your channel ID only. So your channel, this is the channel ID which you are connected to your ThingSpeak. So that channel is collecting the data. And you are using this channel to have the publication of data which is coming from your Raspberry Pi. That is, you're publishing the data. And you're also using the right API key so that it is secured data to be stored there. So then you have created a topic and for your ThingSpeak to be collecting the data, which is published from the device. Then what is this statement, please? Serial, serial dot serial.
To begin serialization.
Yes, you are collecting the serial data from your Raspberry Pi. Okay, now you are in the while one. What does while one indicates?
Infinite loop.
Infinite loop. So you are collecting the data from the sensors data continuously. That is what your infinite loop. So you are taking a temporary variable line, and your line is equal to serial dot read line. The same thing which you are written in the serial program to collect the data. The same instructions. These three instructions, including the importing the serial package, is the same instructions. Only thing is what you are doing with this line is, once you collected that line data, that the line data contains your digital value one and your ADC value of your temperature. So that you are going to give it to another variable called payload. And that payload is appended with this field one, the variable name of your ThingSpeak cloud. And this particular payload once the complete payload is been prepared here, this payload is being published. So you can using a command called publish a single row values one at a time to the topic. To the topic means to the channel ID which your ThingSpeak is connected. And what is the topic contains? The topic contains the payload, that information, the temperature sensor value with the digital value. To the host name, the host name is your MQTT host. The same, you are using the transport protocol TCP, T-transport, your T-transport, you already mentioned here. It is basically the transport mechanism is through your web sockets because you are doing through your web browser here. So coming to that, and you are using the port number. The port number is 80 by default for your TCP data to be. Then you are using the authorization here for the MQTT so that your proper persons are going to communicate or send the data here. So you can use MQTT username and followed by the password. The password is your MQTT API key. So that MQTT API key is basically implies that you are that MQTT protocol is collecting the data. Just that is the statement which you put in your try and exceptions. Once if there is an exception, that is a keyboard, you break it. Otherwise, you tell that if you cannot publish the data to the channel, you say that there was an error in while publishing the data. So this is a very simple program. Collect the serial data and simply publish the data to your cloud. So that's what you will see the program. So of course, I have used this notepad, very simple notepad, to type this Python program. So you need to be careful when you regarding the indentations for the Python, always you know it. So what I do is I'm just collecting the copying this program, and let me just open a new file. I'm just pasting it here now. You can see the program which I have pasted now. So this is a program. If you are not sure about the indentations and everything, if you are not sure about the Python indentations, whether you written correctly or not, can anybody tell me how do you make this program to be indented properly? You can use AutoPEP. AutoPEP is one particular application which will help you to prepare your Python program with proper indentations. So just use AutoPEP hyphen small I interactive mode serial 234.py. That is the name of our Python program. So to run this program, what needs to be done? Anybody? Yes, please. How do you run the program? Hello, am I audible to you?
Python.
In the terminal, I'm typing the command Python 3, name of the Python program, serial 234.py. You can see now on the my. Can you see it on my console? 1203 1204 1203 1205 1204 1204, something is printing here.
Yes sir.
Yeah, the program is running here, which you can see here. And you know, you go to the ThingSpeak. So now you can see that in the ThingSpeak also you are now collecting the data here. You see the graph gets updated. Already the entries are getting less than in a minute. We have received this particular values. So this is around 204, the field value 204. Just now you received April 30, 2021, 942. Just now you have received this value. Entry 71, another value is also received here. This value which has been continuously running, you can see it on my right side screen, and those values here you are displaying it on the. So this is, there is one, yes, there is a one value. It is not zero, it is one. It is one value is there, and your 204 values are there here continuously. Since they are continuously, that much fluctuations are not coming here on your graph here. If you want to see the data that has been collected on the ThingSpeak cloud, you can just go to your export the recent data, click this particular button, and you can see this NKS Pi 1, the channel feed. You have three different formats: JSON format, XML format, and your comma separated values. So you know what is the JSON format is. Now you can see the JSON format data, 207. You have one is there, one followed by 207. You have that your date and the time value is also been mentioned here, and this is an entry number 76, something like this. There are different entries here. If you see the comma separated values, you can download it. And now if you see the XML file, you will get that particular corresponding values. So if you see here, these are the values just now you have been collecting, 77 entries and 78 entries. Of course, this is a UTC time. You can convert that UTC time to the corresponding, but look into the records here. Can anybody tell me what is the problem here in the CSV file, what you see here? And what is the value you see over here? This is the CSV. One second, I will open that particular, hold on. Yeah, so this particular value which you are getting from this temperature sensor and the value which is coming here, can you tell me what is the difference you see here, at least looking to these values? Of course, if you want the latest, once again, I'm just hold on. Before giving the answer, think properly. Okay, I'm just closing the Excel file. Once again, I will try to open the latest Excel file here, the latest CSV file. If you're confused with the JSON, you can open the CSV file. And now come to the recent records. Now you see 81, 82 values are there. Can anybody tell me now? What? Please tell the answer properly so that I will be very much happy. Yes, please.
Out of order data.
How do?
Out of order data.
How to order the data? How to order the data is not the right answer, please.
No, sir. Data that's out of order.
Data is out of order. Oh, okay. You mean to say data is out of order? It is not data is out of order. Why it is not out of order? Can anybody tell me? Actual data which you are getting is 1204, 1203. Of course, 203, 204, 205, 206, 207. That is okay. That is fine. What you see it is actually on your when the program is getting run. But when it is getting stored on the cloud, on the Excel sheet, you see different set of values here. That's what Deepika is telling, that they are out of order, but it is not a question of out of order. If you want to make it into order, can anybody tell me what modification you need to do? Because I have not written in that program, that's why it is looking like an out of order for you. What is the basic problem which I have done here? Anybody?
For that, we need to store in buffer and then send to the cloud.
No, sorry. So no need to store it on the buffer and send it to put it in order. Actually, one small mistake. It's not mistake. Delay. Sorry?
We can add a time delay or something so that.
Time delay is okay. That is one thing. But okay, I just stopped running the program now. You can see it here carefully. Let me open the program and show you once. This Wild Routine Studio always takes a little bit delay here for our opening of programs. Some of you might have already faced this thing. Yes, that is a server problem which you cannot avoid it. So there are limitations, but you have to keep trying on these things. Okay, let me open the program here which I have written on the editor. Okay, now tell me, by looking to this logic in the program, you tell me what is that we need to modify to make it into order. Here what happened is, can anybody tell me how the payload is prepared here? What the payload is containing? Payload contains the line. What is the line contains the value now? The line variable contains the digital value 1 and the ADC value 203, 204. Both the values are there here. Please remember it. You can separate them actually. You can separate them with certain delay here. But what I am asking is, the main problem here is, what you have to understand here is, when the program is getting run, not all the record values are getting stored here, if you might have observed it carefully. If you run the program for continuously one day, then you will understand how many samples of data is being stored in the cloud. If you look here, some values of ones are missing. If you look here, the subsequent 203, 204 of digital temperature values are missing here. Some samples, some records are missing here. That is the reason here, what I'm telling, that is the difference between when the program is getting executed and the data which is being pushed onto the cloud. You are seeing the missing data here. Can anybody tell me why that missing data is happening, or what is the reason behind the data is not getting stored on the cloud, the exact data that is coming from the actual sensor on the Raspberry Pi? Yes, please.
Different data rates.
Data rate also is the same, 9600 bits per second. It is not a question of different data rates. There are communication overheads are there here. Please remember, that is the basic problem of anybody can answer. The basic problem is, cloud computing. That is the basic problem of your cloud. You have an internet connection to your cloud. Your data that is coming from the sensor is not the same exact or the complete data that is getting stored onto the cloud. The problem is since you are storing the data onto the cloud, you are missing some of the data values. You are missing some of the records. You are missing the samples of your sensor data. And sometimes when you are sending the data to the cloud and you are missing some samples, and when you are missing some sensor data, and if suppose the sensors are basically a very vital in an IoT application, and you miss the data, then entire your IoT application purpose is being lost. That is the reason, and that is a drawback of, please fill in the blank.
Transport Hello. Layer overhead.
No, that is not the drawback of transport layer. That is a drawback of your cloud-based IoT. When you are using IoT applications, the cloud computings and the cloud storage and the cloud usage is having a lot of problems. I have taken the latest Excel file. Now you can, of course, I stopped the program. You can see here, sometimes you are not getting the complete data here. You can see it here. That is the main problem here is, you are losing some of the sensor data when you are sending data directly to the cloud. Are you storing locally somewhere in this application? Have you seen, did I store the sensor data locally on my system? This program, I'm just collecting the data serially from the port and I'm publishing directly to the cloud. Am I storing it locally in my system? Hello?
No, sir.
Storing it locally. And if you are directly publishing it to the cloud, of course, whether it is MQTT protocol or any other, or very TCP also, but still you are not receiving the complete data. You are missing some of the data. That's why in the last decade, the cloud computing for the IoT applications has a big drawback, a big disadvantage. People assume that all the sensor data can be directly pushed onto the cloud. I have shown you with a small example how you are having a problem of storing your data on the cloud. In this small example, a lot of information is there for you. Please think properly.
Sir,
that's why, yes, please.
Can we store it in a file and make that file available to the other end?
That is one way. In order to not to miss the data, the important data, you can store it locally. Always the storage of locally is there. But how much, now you're using a Raspberry Pi, right? Do you know how much memory is available to your Raspberry Pi to store the data? If you are going to run this application continuously, your Raspberry Pi doesn't have huge quantity of memory for you to store the data for number of days. Are you getting this point? Cannot be stored, but when you want to store for number of days, the cloud only is the most useful. But the problem with the Raspberry Pi is it is a constrained computing device. That's why constrained device. Raspberry Pis are constrained devices. You have less memory, you have less processing power. The CPU power with respect to your computer or your laptop is less for your Raspberry Pi. So less computing power, less memory, communication problems are there. That's why they are called as Raspberry Pis are resource constrained computing devices. Since you are not storing it, you are losing the sensor data. Please remember that is very much a very important point. That's why now there is a trend in the research community and in the industry. Can you tell me to overcome this cloud computing, what are those two latest technologies which are very much widely used in the current scenario?
Edge computing.
Very good, very good, very good. The edge computing and the one more. Fog computing, very good. These two computings have come into picture now. That is the requirement. That is what the scientific community's requirement. If you are going to do now AI, something, if you are applying AI models onto this data, then it is too difficult for us to deploy AI models on the Raspberry Pi. That's why a lot of research is going on. So many things are happening with respect to edge computing and fog computing. That is the latest trend, and that is what required for us to do. So this is one important point which I like to make you to understand clearly with a practical example. Please do understand this. Of course, this program I will now upload into your course page also. You can also try it from your side, and there will be an assignment related to this. That is assignment 2. Okay, that is one demonstration that we need to understand here. Since we have WildWood in Studio having some problems for us, what I have done is, instead of WildWood in Studio, I'm just exiting from the WildWood in Studio now. So I made another Raspberry Pi. There is a Raspberry Pi 2 for me in my home. So what I have done is I made the Raspberry Pi 2 to connect through SSH and through VNC. So how do you connect another Raspberry Pi to the SSH? So this is what the material is given here. If you go to our course page, so here, you have seen now digital temperature sensor connected to Arduino and then to the USB serial of Raspberry Pi to read serial data and push to the Things Cloud. That particular screen prints are there for you here. Already I have shown you here about this. Then coming to temperature and humidity sensor, DHT11 sensor. I have connected another DHT11 sensor to the Raspberry Pi, another Raspberry Pi, Raspberry Pi 3, in fact. And let us see how do you connect it. So if you open the program here, again, through MQTT, you get it here. And connecting Raspberry Pi through SSH, the steps I have given here. So I have made the Raspberry Pi to be available to the NG-ROC, where I can use using tunneling concept, I make your Raspberry Pi to be available. Of course, this will not be that much problem with your WildWooden server. I will not say that is 100% perfect, but here also some issues may be there, but it is better than WildWood in Studio. That much assurance I can give you. So how do you connect to this one? So I have a tunnels which are already there for me. So this is what this is again free of cost. There is no requirement for this. So I can use these tunnels to help you too. And you can also use this. I'll give the IP addresses for you to connect. So 2 Raspberry Pis, I will make it available from my side for you to do some exercises from now onwards till another 1 month. Time is there for you. So let us see how do you connect here. Let me just save this program and come out of this. So this is the VNC. Let me exit the VNC also for you so that I'll show you from the first step. So that will be useful for you to understand. Okay, first I will show you the connecting your Raspberry Pi through PuTTY. PuTTY, you can call it as a PuTTY. What is a PuTTY? What is the use of a PuTTY, please? Hello, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. just to make sure that I'm online to you. So what is the use of PuTTY? PUTTY, PuTTY application.
At least we can remotely connect to a server kind of thing.
And remotely connect. So if you want to do some kind of, you can see here, remotely log in to another device. You can use this application, PuTTY. So the remote login can be done. What is SSH? In computer networks, you might have studied all these protocols, SSH, R login, remote login, telnet.
Secure shell.
Yes, secure shell. You can securely connect to your remote device. So the remote device here is the Raspberry Pi, and that Raspberry Pi is given with an address here. So 4.tcp.ngrock.io. The important thing is the port number here. Please remember the port number 15352. Sometimes these port numbers will change. So you do not worry when you are unable to connect it. If you send me an email, or if you send me a text message through my WhatsApp or your SMS, then I can tell you the port number so that you can connect to this Raspberry Pi and do the programs. But most of the time it will be, yeah. Now once you connect it, yes, you get. Are you able to see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, login as. So the login as, the username. Username is Pi, and the password is. Where I given the password last time? Can you remember the password?
Raspberry Pi. Raspberry.
No, that is default Raspberry Pi. So don't use the Raspberry Pi, please. And I'm telling you, you remember the passwords and don't share the passwords to not for your classmates, unnecessarily to create problems for you. That is SCISNKS99. If you are connecting to my Pi, the both the Pis, the password is SCISNKS99. So once you connect it here, yes, now you connect. You have connected to this, and you are connecting to another Raspberry Pi. And if you see the, let me just show you in what way I connected here. Can anybody see? Are you able to see this one? The pictures?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can anybody tell me what is the difference between these pictures and the pictures previously I have shown to you?
There's no Arduino.
Yes, there is no Arduino here. Directly, I connected the DHT sensor to the Raspberry Pi GPIO. If you see, can you see my cursor?
Yes.
Yeah. So here, DHT sensor, the DHT 11 sensor here. This is a digital humidity and temperature sensor connected to the GPIO pins of my Raspberry Pi directly instead of Arduino board. There is no requirement for Arduino. Why? What is the reason behind?
It's a digital sensor.
Yes, it is directly digital. You are getting the directly digital value. Already the ADC conversion is happening in this blue color box. That is a digital sensor here. You can see on the right side of the figure, DHT. So this I have given the notes here in what way I connected this digital 11. You can read these notes properly and you can understand it. And of course, you can send the same digital DHT sensor to the cloud also. Of course, that will be the assignment task for you to prepare your own user interface on the cloud for the ThingSpeak cloud, of course. Yeah, that comes to, okay, now let me just run the program here. So the Python program, of course, this will be a little bit. Little bit different from this. So I will show the program for you by executing the through the okay. This is one way you can connect to this SSH through SSH the Raspberry Pi. Let me show you that there's another way also through the VNC player. So the VNC player will help you. You need to have a VNC viewer on your laptop to remotely connect to this one. So this VNC connect, you can. Please, all of you learn these methods. That will be helpful for you in future also. Even if not for IoT, other things also, it will be useful for you. In the VNC viewer, you can give the host name of the same Raspberry Pi. But of course, this will be having a different host name. 8642. Yeah. 1 second, please. Or oh, 2, not comma, this is 2 dot. If you want to view the desktop onto your laptop, this is the way. Through VNC you can do it. Through SSH you cannot view the desktop, but through VNC you can view the desktop. So you can see the desktop here. Can you see the desktop of my Raspberry Pi now?
Yes, sir.
So let me just minimize this, yes, and maximize this, right. So I am now remotely logging to the Raspberry Pi, including the desktop. Of course, the screen doesn't, because of the network delays and the low bandwidth, you will see the colors are not proper here. But nevertheless, you can interact with this. Little bit delay will be there in this VNC player. Now I'm just opening the command prompt. You can see the command prompt here. Little bit delay is here. You can same thing, whatever you want to do through SSH, you can do it here. If you don't want to use this command prompt, since already the GUI is there, you can make just close this one. Then you can go through the Raspberry Pi. Okay. To write the program, if you might remember, 2 weeks back I have given you the introduction to Guinea editor. Do you remember what is the use of that Guinea editor? What programs have you written for us? Again, I am opening the Guinea editor for me here. Yes, please. Can you tell me what programs have you written using Guinea editor over there? Hello.
Yes,
am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Please tell me what programs have you written? Have we written using the Guinea editor? I think you are unable to recollect it. Basically, your serial data. Yeah. Somebody is trying to say. Your serial data that we are going to receive it through the Raspberry Pi, which is connected to the Arduino board again. That was the original experiment, if you remember it. But anyway, this program is basically, you are having a DHT sensor, DHT 11 sensor here. So DHT, the output of the DHT sensor is connected to which particular pin of the Raspberry Pi in this program? Yes, please. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, which particular pin here? The GPIO pin. GPIO pin is connected to 4. Yes, my DHT sensor output is connected to the GPIO 4 here. Right. And if you see here, the package or the library we are using is Adafruit. So this Adafruit package will be helpful for you to quickly write up the program for your collecting the DHT sensor. So Adafruit company, if you please don't take the old programs of Adafruit, because nowadays you have changed the Raspberry Pis, the boards are changed. So please take the latest program, and if you run the old programs, you will not be able to get it. So this Adafruit library, Adafruit underscore DHT library is being imported in this program, and your variable sensor is connected to the Adafruit, the library DHT dot DHT 11 sensor. Sometimes you have a DHT 22 and you have AM 2302 sensors also. If you want to connect, the same package can be used here. Now, a very simple program. So for every 2 seconds, you are going to read the DH digital humidity and temperature values. So the command for this is basically, you can see it here. So Adafruit underscore DHT dot read, read, retry for the sensor that is connected, the DHT 11 and the pin number 4. So this is going to collect the humidity as well as the temperature. And if you are collecting a BMP, it will have also the pressure also is going to be there. So in this sensor, you are only having humidity and temperature. So you are writing it while one. You just collect the data from this sensor and you just print it onto your console here. So this, once you collect it and print it onto the console, you can just see what is the temperature and humidity using the digital temperature. So now tell me, how do you run this program? Yes, please. How do you run the program on the Guinea? Anyone? At least you should know how do you run the program, right? If you're using the Guinea editor. Yes, please.
Project run, sir.
Project run. Okay, very simple things. At least from the menu, you'll get it, the project run. So you can see here, there is an execute. So there is an import error here for the dhtpython.py. So what is this error? How do you correct it?
Install the package.
Yes, very simple. So how do you install it?
Python 3-m pip install.
Yeah, I'm just press return to continue, then come back to this. I'm just minimizing the screen. Go to your shell prompt. Most likely, I have installed this yesterday. Let me just check it once. Okay. I remember now the problem is. So, okay, let me run program from here itself. So now you see the temperature and the humidity values from the DHT sensors are being continuously flashing onto my console screen. Very simple program. Since your Guinea is not been configured for the library, that's why it has given you the error here. But the Raspberry Pi is already installed with the Adafruit DHT. That's why I'm running it from the terminal, from the shell prompt. So you'll be able to run the program here. Of course, it is a continuous values are coming here. Not much variations. Sometimes the sensor, if sensor is not good, you'll not have variations too. This is a very old sensor. So let me just stop here. Yeah. Now the advantage of this connecting through VNC, you can see the desktop also. If you don't want to use the VNC, then it's always preferable to connect through your SSH. That will be most useful for you to write your programs and collect the data. So, who has created? Hello. Who has created an account on the ThingSpeak, please?
I have created, sir.
Okay. Can you able to share your screen? Now you have to connect to this DHT sensor. DHT sensor data has to be displayed on the cloud. So I will help you here. And the session is being recorded. It will help for the others also. So you collect the DHT sensor and put it onto your cloud. Okay. Similarly, the others also can practice like that. You only thing is you have to connect to the Raspberry Pi and connect to your cloud. And I will tell the assignment after that. Once you are able to do this step, then the assignment comes into picture. So by today end, I will put the assignments. Okay. So am I clear to you? What I'm trying to say, convey to you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, let me put code. Yeah, let me put the code of this connecting to the cloud. You can retrieve it from this our course page itself. So let me just upload the code here. And you can again, you can take the program and you start playing with this by adding the code for your DHT sensor from this program. That will be helpful for you. Yeah, Python code to push data onto the ThingSpeak cloud. I have given the program here. You can download it and you start playing this. So let me turn off this one. Okay, first let us complete the demo within 10-15 minutes and I'll come back to the communication protocols, other protocols of the second unit. So Anurag, I think you said that, is it okay?
Yes.
Yeah, so I'll just stop presenting from my side. You present from your side, I'll tell the steps for you.
Sir, are you able to see my screen?
Yeah. Can you maximize it a little bit? 1 second. Hold on.
Sir, now?
1 second, please. Yeah, that's fine. Very good.
Sir, can you see my ThingSpeak tab?
Yes. One second. Yes. The ThingSpeak, you have your profile, your MQTT. Very good. You have the MQTT API keys there?
Yes.
Please go to the channels, your channels. Click channels and my channels. There is a menu item, yes. Channels. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Okay. I think due to delay, it's really slow.
Uh-huh. Click new channel.
Yes.
It is taking time, little bit time. Just hold on. Is your internet speed is very slow?
Yes, I guess, sir.
Yeah. So give one name to this. Some description, no need. Just field one. In the field one, you put field one only. But actually, you need to make two fields here. One is for humidity, another for temperature. Later, you have to do this. You enable that, yes. No. Put field one and field two for you to not have confusion.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Yes, please. Yeah. Scroll down. Save the channel. Yes.
Save channel, sir.
Yes. Okay, just keep this like this. Okay, now you connect to
sir.
Connect. You have PuTTY application on your system.
No, sir.
You can download it now. You better connect to through SSH. You can connect through SSH or you can connect through VNC also. Do you have VNC player?
No, sir.
Both of them are not there. Okay, you just go to Google. Just go to Google there. Are you in Windows or Linux? Linux, huh?
Sir, you can use terminal.
Sam in Linux, sir.
Okay, then go to Linux then. Terminal.
Sir,
yeah,
terminal.
Install PuTTY.
Okay, sir.
Open the PuTTY now.
Yes, sir. Done, sir.
No, yeah, installation is done. Open PuTTY. No, on the terminal, you don't know how to open an application in Linux? Yeah.
So I've opened PuTTY.
Where did you open? Your screen is not getting. Right, fine. So here. Yeah, enter now. Two dot. Shall I paste it here? TCP dot.
Yes, sir.
I just pasted on the chat window.
Sir, please. Can you pin the?
Yeah, yeah. In the port number, you have to enter 18642. I could not see your PuTTY application, Baba.
So it's showing unable to open. Name or service is not known.
Remove.
Okay, then enter the another one. 1 second.
Okay. So one.
Have you entered wrongly? No, TCP. You remove TCP. Open your PuTTY again.
Yes, sir.
Enter two dot. TCP dot ngrok dot io. In the port number, you type yes. Remove that yes. 18642. Other students also can log in here to the SSH. You can also log in. There is no problem.
So server unexpectedly closed network connection.
You just try the second one. Four dot. Yeah, no,
sir, accept sir, giving the server's host key.
No, accept okay. It. That is what security that is. Secure me. Okay, login as PI. Already yes. It is connected. I cannot
password?
See your. PI. I told you the password.
We
Did you get it, the password? I have
no, SES in.
Okay. In the chat window, it is there. Yes, connected.
Yes, I have logged into it.
Yes, now ls minus l. Yes, do you have that? Can you? I cannot see the program. It's very small letters.
So
1 second. Let me adjust my screen also. There is a DHT Python will be there, okay. No?
Yes, sir. It's present.
Yeah, you just run the program. Python 3 space DHT Python dot py. Yeah, maximize that screen, please.
So it's not giving any output.
Just press enter.
So it's giving you.
Yeah. Okay, now stop. This is temperature and humidity at my place now.
Okay.
Okay. So now I have given you the program for you to connect to the cloud. Open the program.
Which is in Moodle.
For you to publish data onto the cloud. Download the program.
Okay, sir. So the last one, Python code to push data onto things picture.
Yes, please.
Yes, it's downloaded.
Open the program now. Yes. Now, what are all the changes you have to do? You need not have the package.
I have to change it. Okay. I'll solve it, sir.
And you put your channel ID there. You write your API key there. Your MQTT host and your MQTT username and the MQTT API key. Please enter your data there, your cloud data.
Okay, sir.
Your my code, you'll get the whole remaining data there.
My own, sir.
My profile.
So MQTT. Where do I get my MQTT username?
Username is there in the top, no? your MQTT username. Ah, there it is. There. Okay. Copy that.
Okay. So
the remaining things.
Yes, sir.
You have to just say. But now, hold on. That you open this code and put that BST census data collection over there.
So which sir, I didn't get.
Your DHT Python dot py. Open the DHT Python dot py program and see the program. What are the statements are there? That you have to, those statements. You bring it here.
Okay, sir.
Put it in a new file. Again, you'll get confused. Please keep in a new file. Later, you can combine.
Okay. Sir, write the program. Sir, I'm not able. Like I'm not able to copy it, sir. Like I'm not able to copy it. I'll type the program, sir.
You will type the program. You complete. Day will be over. You can copy it, Baba.
No, sir. Not able to copy it, sir.
SSH is
there. Yes, sir.
Okay. You take only those statements here. The first statement will be. I'll just tell the statements. You just type the statements over there.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Import Adafruit underscore DHT. Underscore is there or not?
Yes, it's there.
Okay. Yeah, sensor is equal to Adafruit underscore DHT dot, yes, DHT 11, yes. Then GPIO is equal to 4, yes, sensor 4, yes. Then while 1.
So we need to take humidity and temperature.
First the variables has to be, yes. Adafruit, yes, underscore DHT, read, retry, very good. Sensor, comma, GPIO. While true, okay. Yes, print a floating point format for temperature and humidity. You can see the format there if you are not sure about that. Yeah. Now these are the statements. Now you bring one by one statement to that file.
So this
put the import package. Yeah, go to the import. Yes, there. You remove the serial now because we are not collecting the data from the serial there. Serial is not required. Yes. Okay. Even that PS util also is not required. That is unnecessary packages there. Remove that.
Yes.
Okay. Random is also not required. I just put the some sample file from the net only. That's why you don't all these packages are not required. Yeah. Okay. Now come back to this. Yes. Yeah. Just put it all these three first values there. All three statements.
I'm keeping on the TCP T ports.
You can hold on. Just hold on. I cannot see your statement. Just hold on. Go back to the program once.
So here I have kept.
Where you kept? Okay. After topic only you keep it.
Okay, sir.
Remove those serial lines there. Our previous programs. File. Yes. So while one.
Line.
Yeah. Remove those things. Yes. Now you paste those things there.
So this while true.
Yes.
Sir, should I paste the if else condition or complete the while true? In the
complete while statement as it is, you paste it because anyway it is a continuous loop only.
So I should remove this this while statement.
No, within that while only the same logic, Amma. It is a continuous statement. Put it there. No, don't write while true again. Remove that. Okay, while one or while true doesn't make any difference. Both are same. Yeah, come down. Now just you need to look for this payload properly.
So this
payload is equal to field one is equal to your
temperature
or humidity, whatever it may be. Plus plus field 2 within quotes plus str
yes,
of humidity.
Okay, sir.
Oh, your connection is lost there, SSH. Again,
yes,
sir. Because you are not using, that's why it has lost the connection. You need to connect through SSH again.
Okay, sir. Sir.
Yes, please. Now let me just check the program. Payload is prepared properly. Topic is done properly, no? Yes. Yeah, save
yes,
the program
sir.
And now you run it. Run the program on that terminal.
So first I need to install Pahoa and Adafruit, right, sir?
Yeah.
No,
not on your system, Baba. You don't require on your system.
So this Pahoa.
No, it is not running on your system. No, you just run the program over there. Copy the program onto the Raspberry Pi, onto the Raspberry Pi terminal.
I didn't get you, sir.
You have this Raspberry Pi terminal, right? Open a new.
Yes,
open
sir.
Vi space. Anurag.dht.py. Enter. Paste your program over there now.
Sir, okay, but I think I may not be able to paste it, sir. Like it's SSH.
It will paste it. You first copy paste there. You go to insert mode first. insert mode.
Yes, sir.
Insert, right click, paste.
So 1 minute, sir. No, sir, I'm not able to paste here, sir.
Are you on the insert or append mode?
So insert only, sir.
Insert or append mode. Oh, you are able to type it, huh? Okay. You need to bring that file, this program instructions over there into that file, and you are running from that Raspberry Pi.
You can do SFTP, sir.
Sir, is the gedit in this?
Sorry?
Gedit. Like a GUI edit.
Okay. You use nano otherwise? Nano.
It's not coming.
Usually on my system it comes. Have you copied it properly or not?
Yes, I have copied it.
What is that?
Yes, I have copied it. No, I just checked whether I have copied it or not.
First, you save the program in your local disk.
Oh, okay, so it's saved.
One second, you select copy and paste it there. In Nano, you will not get it. At least VI, open the VI editor again. Control.
I guess I have copied into my clipboard, sir. So that's why there is no shared clipboard for this SSH. I think that's why it's not able to paste in.
Yes. Most likely, yeah. So how do you bring?
Sir, logging in through SSH through our port. So our terminal will help, sir. I'm able to pay if I do it from my terminal.
Sorry?
Anurag, if I go to your terminal and say SSH-P port number and pi at the rate port.
SSH?
You enter the address I have given to you, yeah.
So SSH and?
Minus P.
Minus T.
Yeah.
P for port. Minus P.
Yeah.
It's minus P.
Okay, Prano, just type the command in the chat.
Yeah, I'll type.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Nano and that file name and paste it. control shift key.
Okay. Sure. Yes, sir.
Yeah, save it now.
One minute, sir.
DD, don't save it with A. Extra character is there.
Okay.
Remove all those lines. In the escape mode, press DD.
Yes, it's not.
Yeah, so many are there. You just keep on pressing DD. Small DD.
Nothing is there. One minute, sir. I'll just write file down.
Yeah, now just in the escape mode only, WQS hash, exclamatory mark. Enter.
Yes.
Open the program once.
Sir.
Okay, hopefully, I think some extra get. Anyway, now you write Python 3 on the program.
It's saying no module power phone, sir.
Yes, install sudo pip3.
Okay.
Install pahoo -mqtt.
Mqtt.
Why you don't give space there?
Okay.
Yeah, run the program again. Yeah, now you are displaying this. Go to your TeamSpeak cloud. Open that private, yes. Private. Yeah, values are coming there.
There's only field one value is coming, sir. No field two value.
Yeah, this is only temperature value is coming.
Here it's showing temperature humidity, but
your program, of course, values are coming there. Temperature values are coming. Humidity values are not coming. Can you tell me what is the problem again? You go to the problem and you can rectify it. Okay, anyway, this is how you can get it now. Go to your JSON file. The field 2 humidity value has to be displayed. You correct the program in your line there.
Okay.
No, not field 2.
Sure.
Go to the channel. Export. Yes. Channel, yes. JSON.
Sir.
Okay, JSON values are coming here anyway.
So it's showing null. I think.
Is null. You are not put the values properly of the field 2 in the program. Instead of that concatenating, you put it in a different way and send it as a payload. Anyway, so that is one thing. I just waited for all of you to see how the things goes on so that you can do it on your own. I hope others are able to follow this demonstration.
Yes, sir.
Irfan, are you online? Yeah, Deepika.
Yes, sir.
Deepika.
Yes, sir.
Have you followed this demo, Subham?
Yes, sir.
Subham.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. Sonali.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Syed. Imtiaz.
Yes, sir.
Rupesh. Have you followed the demo? How do you send the data to the cloud?
Yes, sir.
Hindu? Hindu, are you online? Yeah. Yeah. So I think this, please go through this very, very important step for IoT applications to be displayed on the cloud. So can you stop presenting, Anurag? I have a little bit to discuss.
Yes, sir.
So here, of course, we have seen how the things can be published onto the cloud, and the same steps has to be replied. How do you display this on the MySQL database? Before going through this, I have a small topic to be discussed. So IoT communication protocols. So what communication protocols have you seen so far? Hello, am I audible to you? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Audible. So far we have seen MQTT protocol. Only one protocol we have discussed. How do you send and how do you publish? Of course, you have not seen the subscription also, but we will see it in the later stage. So if you see this diagram, basically you will get a overview of. You are having different types of sensors, something like this for a medical application. So through your, you are sending all this data, basically you are publishing the data and you are having a subscription on the other side. Subscription can be through your applications or through different set of devices. So any in IoT, basically you have this MQTT, but you also have another protocol called Constraint Application Protocol. So this is what we are going to discuss here a little bit on Constraint Application Protocol. So this, if you see the difference between MQTT and Constraint Application Protocol, MQTT for the application layer, it is completely a single layered one, whereas you have a message request and the response layer for Constraint Application Protocol. So you have seen just now, you're using the TCP protocol to wrap your MQTT data, whereas CoAP runs on UDP. So reliability, you have MQTT is more reliable than CoAP. But if you are having more data to be sent, then people do prefer for CoAP. So of course, MQTT supports the publish-subscribe model, whereas CoAP goes with request-response, something like your equivalent to your REST API exchange of data. So this is a basic difference between the MQTT and CoAP. So in the next Tuesday's class, we'll see how CoAP is going to be used. And I have given you a little bit material on MQTT. Of course, I'm not going to read out. You can just see and discuss, and we can discuss it later. Just go through this. And along with this Constraint Application Protocol also, I have given the material to you, the basic important points. So how the data transfer is taking place between the MQTT and the CoAP. So this is the architecture which we have just seen. The MQTT node, that is what your Raspberry Pi is been wrapped up with your TCP, and it is been communicated to the ThingSpeak cloud. So of course, we have not seen the entire realization of this architecture, but at least the one way of data is being transmitted to your ThingSpeak cloud. So if you look to the other communication protocols, we have something called wireless fidelity. So this wireless fidelity protocol is basically IEEE 802.11 standards of different variations do exist for our IoT things for different data rates. And most of you might have learned in the computer networks course about the different standards for this Wi-Fi standards for your data transmission. So these things are also going to be useful for us. And with respect to the Bluetooth, the very small range communication data transfer between the devices can also be using through Bluetooth. So this some material which is given, please go through the material. This basics of about our networkings, and that will be useful for us. So next week on Tuesday's class, I will go about the CoAP protocol, and that completes the second unit of our discussion. So on coming Sunday, we have our mid exam. I hope you all are aware of that one, right?
Yes, sir.
Great. So please go through this IoT communication protocols. It will be useful for you to quickly have the idea about what I have discussing through these videos and all. So one small thing I like to just give. Let us go through the VNC, and in this VNC viewer, if you see, you are using 4 dot, no? That is what you are using 4 dot. So let me just go to 18642. Other one. So let me connect through VNC player. Let me come out of this ThingSpeak. This is what this one. So I am connecting the same Raspberry Pi what Anuragi has connected, but I am connecting through VNC player. So you can see it on my screen now. This is how the VNC player will help you to have your remote desktop. A little bit delay will be there, but it's already connected. I can see this cursor pointer on my monitor too. It is getting connected, just hold on. Sometimes some delays in network issues always will be there. Please do have to bear with the patience of this one. Yeah, so once you connect it here, I have installed. Can you tell me what are the things that I have installed here? I'm just running something here.
So the packages you mean?
No. I have not typed it. Please hold on. See, I'm running something here. Please see what is that. You have to tell me what I have installed on this one. You can tell it also.
LAMP.
Yeah, the LAMP server is installed on this. You can see I am connecting to the PHP MyAdmin. So I connected even the LAMP server on the same Raspberry Pi. Are you getting this point, please? I hope everybody has already done the LAMP server and the programming.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So the second assignment, the same thing. Now, can you tell me what will be the second assignment, what I'm trying to give to you?
Store the collected data in DB server.
Very good. So you need to store your data on the database server, as well as the one question is on that you have to store the data on the database locally. That is one exercise. And the other exercise is to have a subscription, the MQTT subscription from your cloud server onto your web page. You can create your own web page here. So you know how to create your web pages. Each one of you create your own folders and you put your source codes onto this, okay? Are you able to get my point, please? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So that will be the assignment two. That
sir,
is the
I...
most, yeah. Tell me, what is
sir,
your
sir, I didn't get by creating, we should be creating the folder, sir.
You have to create your folders on the Raspberry Pi only.
Okay.
I will be running the programs on this browser with your source codes.
Yes.
So anyway, that questions will be displayed on the course webpage by today evening. You can see the assignment two questions. So on Sunday, we are meeting again to have our test. So any doubts regarding that?
Awesome.
Is it okay then? So we'll be winding up the session now for today.
Sir?
Yes, please.
the sensor, the sensors and all which will be connected to the Raspberry Pi, okay, could you provide those pin numbers or GPIO pin numbers by, so that we can
It is in the program only. You have seen, no, the sensor, the DHT sensor which I directly connected to the Raspberry Pi is connected to GPIO 4.
Okay, sir.
That
like,
is one.
Okay, yes, sir. Okay.
So far, I have shown you two sensors.
Yes, sir.
One is the KY028 and another is DHT11. I will show you another 2-3 sensors there in the next classes, and as well as Pi camera, the remaining weeks. Yeah. Is it okay?
Sir, yes. One more doubt, sir. Like the programs will be in Python, sir. Like, so, or there again, we'll have to write the similar code in PHP again, I guess, no, sir. If we have to publish a website in LAMP stack.
LAMP stack?
Can we use Django or Flask?
If you want to use anything, but because those tools are available on the Raspberry Pi now, you have to run the program on the Raspberry Pi, number one. To collect the data, you can write the program through Python only. No need to write the program through PHP to collect the data and store the data in the MySQL.
Yes, sir.
So why PHP will come there to collect the data from the sensors? If you want to write, you can write it, but there is no point. Already, you know, you already written the program of Python how to collect the data. Only thing is to store the data. So what changes have to be made here now? What things has to be added?
The SQL.
That's it. SQL connection.
Yes,
yeah, connections. You have to prepare the statement and insert the data, which you had already done in your previous. If I remember, internet technologies only. I told you how to insert the data into your database tables.
Sir, there's also a Python SQL library which can be used to store data in databases.
Yes. You can use it. Use it, no problem. It is programming wise, the tools and the logic is always flexible to you. I'm not restricting you to follow only one, but I'm telling you, unless you yourself don't explore too many things there with your complex ideas, make your life very simple. That's all. Okay. But at least the things has to be completed. If you're not clear, you can query to me and you can clarify. There's no problem. For this program, what I told you is you need to just write the same Python program. You need to write the MySQL statements, Python with MySQL statement to collect the data and store it in the database table. That is one exercise. The other exercise is to collect the data from the ThingSpeak cloud and to display it on the web page. That is the second exercise.
Okay, sir.
Any other doubts, please? Yeah. If there are no doubts, then we'll wind up the session for today. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.